A soggy Wednesday evening here in northeastern Cincinnati. We are at the home of the Lebanon Warriors. Lebanon Junior High School taking on the West Clermont Wolves. Some Eastern Cincinnati Conference baseball on ICRC-TV. Pleasure to have you with us. I'm Josh Semstrat here to bring you the sights and sounds of the game. We are getting started early today as a first pitch is roped into center field. Austin Randolph gets it started with a shot in the shallow left center. Grant Kefeber, the junior, our starting pitcher for the Lebanon Warriors today. Pitch inside, taken by Connor Kasten. Kefeber will throw over. Yeah, like I said, we originally scheduled for a 5 o'clock first pitch here at Lebanon Junior High School. Weather moving in, if not already here, as Kasten fouls one off. But with even heavier rain moving in later this evening, went ahead and found an earlier start time. Luckily, our ICRC-TV productions were able to get out here, get set up for you, but we are rushing into this and going to try and get baseball in before that weather arrives. 1-2 count now for Kasten. Kefeber looks over, throws over. Kefeber, 8 innings pitched on the year. 2.5 whip. The 1-2 pitch. Taken to the shortstop. He'll look 2. They'll go over to 1. Nope, he'll hold it. Not in time. Speedy wheels there for Connor Kasten. But the Warriors get the lead runner at second for their first out of the game. Like I said, we are getting started early here. Didn't we even have an anthem or starting lineup player introduction, so we'll try and get everyone introduced as we see them. Kefeber low and away. It's Hunter Stoltz at the plate for the West Clermont Wolves. Stoltz, 286 hitter this season. Kefeber comes high and inside. Kefeber leads the Lebanon Warriors in strikeouts, 12 strikeouts on the year. Runner goes, throw, and just skipped early in the grass and over second base. That'll be a stolen base for Connor Kasten. His fourth stolen base of the year. So 3-0 count now. For Stoltz, swings on the 3-0 and hits a chopper to the shortstop who won't be able to get the throw in time. The throw goes over the first baseman and out of play, so runners will advance. And they are going to say that Kasten was around and will take home. So the West Clermont Wolves are on the board first here in the top of the first. still one out, a man on second for the Wolves. Keffer will go to work. Runner goes to third. The throw. Got him.
What do you got, Jack?
So Stoltz gunned down at third. And that gives Keffer some relief as now the bases are cleared. Two outs. Keffer delivers a strike. Kyle Gillespie. Gillespie fouls one off. Gillespie, 211 hitter on the year. Gillespie back in. Keffer back on that mound. That mound was covered just up until first pitch. Ball outside. As you can see, a good amount of rain on your camera there. But nothing too heavy thus far. Definitely some soggy playing conditions. 1-2 pitch from Keffer. Fouled off. Gillespie driven in 5 RBIs so far this season. So we get into the thick stuff here in April, the heavy part of the varsity baseball schedule. Both these teams in the middle of quite a busy week. That pitch in the dirt evens us up 2-2. Two-two pitch from Keffer is outside, brings us full. Lebanon Warriors in the middle of a 3-game homestand and a 2-game win streak. Wins off of Wayne and a Little Miami. Full count, 2 outs, Keffer. Nice pitch inside, rings him up and ends the inning. So Keffer just gives up the 1, but after the top of the first, West Clermont leads. You stick around on ICRC-TV.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. It made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Welcome back to Lebanon, Ohio. The West Clermont Wolves have a lead over the home team Lebanon Warriors. This is Eastern Cincinnati Conference Baseball on ICRC-TV. Josh Semsrott, happy to be with you. Rushing in to an early start, trying to get some baseball in before the weather. The Lebanon Warriors try and get some offense on the board. Warriors 3-6 on the season, 1-5 in the conference. Keith Schilt, head coach in his first season here with the Lebanon Warriors. But the Lebanon Warriors are defending co-champions of this conference with the West Clermont Wolves. West Clermont Wolves coming into this game 2-5 and a 1-4 record in the conference. So the Eastern Cincinnati Conference right now kind of divided into three tiers as we are early in the season. And with a win today, one of these teams can kind of move themselves out of the basement and into that middle tier. Dave Collins managing the West Clermont Wolves. And on the mound for the Wolves is Caden Yearwood, the junior. Yearwood's first pitch is outside and leading off for the Lebanon Warriors, Ben Fitch, the senior. Yearwood delivers a strike, evens the count at one. Ben Fitch, 400 average on the year, 556 on base percentage. This one comes up near his head. Fitch ducks out of the way, and some jeers from the Lebanon crowd. Fitch also 10 hits, 3 stolen bases, the leadoff hitter in every sense of the word. 2-1 count. Yearwood kicks, delivers, this time inside. Kevin Yearwood, one of, if not the ace of this team, a 1.05 ERA. This one just catches the black. Fitch was thinking first base, but he'll stay here with a full count. Fitch cracks one over the short baseman. Shortstop. Fitch is in there with the leadoff single. So just like West Clermont started at the top of the first, or bottom of the first starts with a shallow little crack into left center. We'll see if the Lebanon Warriors can't even this game up in the early stages. Peyton Livingston up to bat now for the Warriors. Pops one foul. Yearwood rocks, glances over his shoulder, delivers, and the bunt laid down by Livingston. Great bunt there, moves the runner. And a textbook little drop, moving Ben Fitch over to second. So Livingston does his part. Now it's Grant Kiefaber. Apologize to Grant and his family. Still getting the pronunciations and the starters as we go here with the early start. Starting a half hour early than originally intended. Yearwood's pitch is hit shallow opposite field. Runner did not tag up. And Peyton Livingston has doubled up at second. Thought that one was hit softer than it was into shallow right, but the double play ends the innings. Get Yearwood out of trouble. Second inning, just moments away.
If you love them enough to crawl into a play place to get them to come down, then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
When it comes to making plans, you are the best. What about those barbecues you plan in detail for your family? or your daughter's first costume party.
It was out of this world. The same way you plan each detail for those moments, start planning to protect you and your loved ones from a natural disaster. Sign up for local weather and emergency alerts. Prepare an emergency kit and make a family communications plan. Protecting your family is the best plan you can make.
Hi, I'm Smokey Bear, and I made an assistant to help you prevent wildfires.
Dude, I've got this. I've been camping since I was 5 years old.
But I am a camping influencer.
You know what? I'll bet you $5.
Okay.
Assistant Smokey, what is the best way to put out a campfire?
Mm-hmm.
To put out a campfire, drown with water, stir, drown again, then make sure the fire is out cold by feeling with the back of your hand.
Wait, really?
I'll take the $5.
Thank you for joining us today on ICRC-TV. Some Eastern Cincinnati Conference varsity baseball. Varsity baseball season here in Cincinnati. In the early stages, if you can't tell, the soggy afternoons, cold, misty wind, a staple of springtime baseball here in the Natty. But a great facility here at Lebanon High School. In the middle of their legacy project, phase one, updating a lot of their athletic facilities, making some updates to their high school as well. A little news in the district as we get underway here in the top of the second. Grant Kefeber going to work on Caleb Darosette. One-oh pitch, again up high. And you can tell a little flick of the hand and kick in the dirt there for Kefeber. Things are soggy out there. So Kefeber works into a 3-0 count here. Just the Wolves have already green-lighted once in the first inning on 3-0. We'll see what Darosette does here. Takes that one down the middle. Kefeber gets him swinging there. And Kefeber's worked back to full count now. Kefeber, full count, kicks and deals, and it's in the dirt. So Kefeber will walk the leadoff hitter in Caleb Darosette. Jack Schreck, the junior, behind the dish for Kefeber today. We'll have more on Schreck later. Nice standout transfer to Lebanon High School. And the catching situation for the Warriors, dire early in the season due to some key injuries. So Kefeber now with the man on, delivers a first pitch strike. Big 99 at the dish for the Wolves, Gavin Speranza, the junior. Speranza, 333 hitter on the year. Another good-looking pitch from Kefeber, and quickly it's 0-2. Kefeber looks in. You see him look back at his first baseman. This time throws over. Keeping Darosette honest. Gets him swinging, throw down. What a catch and what a tag! throw was wide, but Ben Fitch able to go up there, grab that, and somehow then get the tag down on Darrow Set. And boy, I tell you, Jack Schreck with an arm behind the dish, that's the second guy he's thrown out this afternoon. So the old K throwdown double play for the Warriors. Quickly out of trouble with two outs here in the second inning. Jacob Huddleston at the plate now, and he swings at one in the dirt. Huddleston, not a lot of action so far this year, only two at-bats logged. Another low pitch for Kefieber. It's time. Be laid off. Big swing from Huddleston there, and it's 2-2. Fieber gets him looking, strikes him out, and ends the inning. Great comeback after the walk for Kefieber there. So to the bottom of the second we go, West Clermont.
Hi, I'm Smokey Bear, and I made an assistant to help you prevent wildfires.
Dude, I've got this. I've been camping since I was 5 years old.
But I am a camping influencer.
You know what? I'll bet you $5.
Okay.
Assistant Smokey, what is the best way to put out a campfire?
Mm-hmm.
To put out a campfire, drown with water, stir, drown again, then make sure the fire is out cold by feeling with the back of your hand.
Wait, really?
I'll take the $5.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. It made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Welcome back to Lebanon High School. Lebanon Warriors and West Clermont Wolves on ICRC-TV. We're in the bottom of the second. Wolves lead. First pitch to Jack Schreck, a strike. It's time Schreck watches one. For Jack Schreck, stepping up in a big way for the Lebanon Warriors, an ECC Athlete of the Week for his performances last week. He puts one down to the second baseman in routine ground ball. Schreck is sat down. Jack Schreck, he transferred to Lebanon this year, and right at the beginning of the season, the first-string catcher and second-string catcher went down for the Lebanon Warriors, and Schreck, not having any varsity experience before, really stepped up that first week of April, hit .571, 8 for 14, including three doubles, three RBIs, a stolen base, and threw out three of the five runners who tried to steal on him that week. He's currently hitting .481 on the young season, and .563 since being named the full-time starting catcher in the third game of the season. So those first two games, a catcher each goes down with a significant injury, and Jack Schreck, transferring without any varsity experience, has stepped up huge for the Lebanon Warriors. Also leading in the classroom with a 3.8 GPA. So well-earned ECC Athlete of the Week honors for Jack Schreck. Now it is 3-1 to Ryan Land, though. Ryan Land, the senior, hitting .292 on the year. Caden Yearwood, the 3-1 pitch, popped into the shallow center field. Center fielder is under that to make the putout. I believe that's Hunter Schultz out there. Wyatt Minnick now for the Warriors. The junior's had a decent season so far, .333 average, and he cranks one into left field, and that'll get by the left fielder. And that'll be an easy stand-up double for Wyatt Minnick. Minnick's second double of the year. So a two-out double. We'll see if the Warriors are able to do anything with it. The junior Cam Coleman will have said opportunity. Yearwood will look the runner back and come to the plate. Fouled down the first baseline, out of play. Coleman, a .316 hitter on the year. 500 on base percentage. Yearwood's pitch catches the outside edge. Nice play by the left fielder. Just brings the shallow line drive down from Coleman, and the inning is over. So still 1-0 Wolves as we go to the third.
If you love them enough to crawl into a play place to get them to come down, then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
When it comes to making plans, you are the best. What about those barbecues you plan in detail for your family? Or your daughter's first costume party? It was out of this world. The same way you plan each detail for those moments, start planning to protect you and your loved ones from a natural disaster. Sign up for local weather and emergency alerts. Prepare an emergency kit and make a family communications plan. Protecting your family is the best plan you can make.
Welcome back to Lebanon High School Eastern Cincinnati Conference Baseball on ICRC-TV. Josh Semstrott, pleased to be with you on this soggy afternoon as we try and get some baseball in. Last year's ECC co-champions, Lebanon, West Clermont. The Wolves have the early edge. We hit the top of the third. Grant Kefieber on the mound for the Warriors. And Thomas DeHatt, the junior, for the Wolves. DeHatt swings away. 1-1 the count. Kefieber looks in, kicks and deals outside. DeHatt fouls one off. DeHatt 0-4 on the season. Not a lot of opportunities for the junior. It is early in the season, though. This Wolves team, 238 at the plate as a team. Kefieber's pitch is up high, brings us full. Not necessarily one of the better hitting teams in the ECC, but one of the better on the mound. Wolves come into this game with a +1 run differential. They've scored 5 or less runs in 4 of their last 5 games. They'll return home tomorrow and much needed. DeHatt steps out, calls time. DeHatt staying alive. A couple foul balls in this full count. That one gets him swinging, but it's in the dirt. Schreck, his throw down to first. And DeHatt sat down. It's Kefieber, his third strikeout of the game. Starting to settle in. Is Grant Kefieber, the junior. His first pitch, shot, foul, first base side, and making the catch, the first baseman. So nice, right on the edge of the fence there, put out for the Lebanon Warriors. Kefieber's quickly got 2 outs. So we are back to the top of the lineup. Austin Randolph at the plate, singled in his first at bat. Kefieber, the 0-1. Outside. One pitch from Kefieber. Inside. Austin Randolph, the leadoff hitter for the Wolves, and the batting leader in the ECC, at least in terms of batting average, came into this game with a .500 batting average, .625 on base percentage. So Kefieber's got 2 outs, but staring down the Wolves' leadoff hitter and the leading hitter in the conference. Pitch outside, and it's 3-1. Kefieber outside. And Randolph will earn himself a base on balls. So you get a look there at the number two man, Connor Caston, for the Wolves. Just two RBIs for Caston so far this year. Grounded into the fielder's choice in his first at bat. Takes his first pitch for a ball. Fieber another in the dirt. Shrek can't handle it, and it'll be no throw down at second, and a stolen base for Randolph. His sixth stolen base of the year. Fieber kick steals down Broadway for Kefieber. Little missed here, but Rain still holding off at Lebanon Junior High, home of the varsity baseball field. Little dribbler. Kefieber will come off the mound and throw is high and brings the first baseman off the plate. Third runner rounding third had slipped and fallen down. First baseman made the throw over. And that ball is still slick out there, as we were talking about. Mishandled twice by the Warriors and allows the runner to reach at first and allows the run to come in from second base. So Randolph has reached twice, scored twice. And runner will go again. This time Shrek fields it cleanly. Throw down. Just safe. Ben Fitch was already running back. Thought they had made the play there. So Connor Caston gets his stolen base. First stolen base. The second stolen base of the game. Excuse me. Hunter Stoltz at the dish, RBI single earlier. Crowded infield there on your screen as you see Kefieber looking back, his pitch in the dirt. Brings us to 2-2. 1-2 count. 1-2 count. Kefieber gets him swinging again in the dirt. Shrek handles. Throw down. Got him. So Kefieber struck out the last man he faced in each inning to end each one. But the West Clermont Wolves add another run. It's 2-0 here. You're watching ICRC-TV.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. It made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Welcome back to Lebanon, Ohio. The Warriors hosting the West Clermont Wolves in some Eastern Cincinnati Conference baseball action. Mentioned this much-needed homestand that the Wolves are about to go on, the West Clermont Wolves. This is their last road game on this little trip around Cincinnati they've done. They'll come home for a three-game homestand starting tomorrow. Got a game Friday. Have the weekend off and a home game Monday. Then eight of their next 10 games after this little homestand are on the road. So the Wolves could definitely use the road win here. Some momentum into the weekend. After that, it's quite the tough travel schedule for the Wolves. And April, such a packed schedule if you followed the varsity baseball circuit. Not a lot of days off for these kids. It's Caden Yearwood on the mound for the Wolves still. Though he's down early 2-0. Make it 2-1. Hayden Massenheimer, pinch hitter. He cranked one out there to left field. And a good contact there, but Massenheimer flies out.
Now batting for the Warriors, number 13, Bryce Bowman.
Bryce Bowman into the game now for the Warriors. His first pitch in the dirt from Yearwood. Bryce Bowman, only a couple at-bats this year. For the Warriors, they're in the middle of enjoying a three-game homestand themselves right now. We'll have another game tomorrow as they host the LaSalle Lancers coming in from downtown Cincinnati. Some cool, you can call them road games, neutral games for the Lebanon Warriors this year. They still got a game up at Day Air Park, home of the Dayton Dragons, single-A affiliate, the Cincinnati Reds. So Yearwood gets a swing from Bowman there, evens us 2-2. They'll face Kings at Day Air Park on the 24th of April. Yearwood's 2-2 pitch fouled off behind the plate. And then the Lebanon Warriors will also be up that way in the Dayton area, taking on Chaminade Julien May 4th up at Wright State. So some cool games on the schedule for the Warriors. Yearwood low and away, and a good look from Bryce Bowman there, who's worked a full count. The junior steps back in. Yearwood looks. Yearwood sits him down with a swinging strikeout. So Yearwood finally gets a K today. His ninth strikeout this year.
Now batting for the Warriors, number one, Ben Fitch.
Back to the top of the lineup for the Lebanon Warriors as Ben Fitch steps in. Fitch singled over the shortstop in his first appearance. Watches a pitch high here. We talked about the West Clermont Wolves coming into this game with their plus one run differential. And this one's cranked into left field there, but easy can of corn. And we'll finish that thought on the other side as we head to the fourth inning. West Clermont leads 2-0. You're watching ICRC-TV.
I
felt accomplished after I got my diploma. It made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Get a look at Lebanon Junior High School in the background there. As you see Grant Kefieber warming up. 4Ks on the day for him. We'll see what he can do against the Wolves here in the fourth inning. Going back to that point we were making about the run differentials before we took our break there. Again, West Clermont Wolves coming in with +1 run differential. The third least runs mount scored in the conference. The Lebanon Warriors, 5 of their last 9 games, there's been a combined 15, at least 15 combined runs in 5 of their last 9 games. They come into this with a -18 run differential, but have scored the third most runs in the conference, but lead the conference in runs allowed. So these teams... One of Lebanon Warriors, great hitting team, a lot of smack at the plate. But for the West Clermont Wolves, some great defense. Definitely the more senior team here, and great on the bump are the Wolves. Grant Kefieber. Down on the count early. It's Kyle Gillespie here. In the top of the fourth for the Wolves, he hits a little dribbler. Fielded off the grass by the Warriors' second baseman. An easy put out, Ben Fitch. He's had a few easy ones over there today. Fitch, outstanding grab and tag in the first inning. Fieber's first pitch in the dirt to Caleb Dorsett. Dorsett walked his first appearance. Little mound visit there between Shrek and Kefieber. And Kefieber, this one runs inside and will get the feet of Caleb Dorsett. So Dorsett will get on for the second time today. One just ran away from Kefieber. We've seen the ball get a little slick at times today and be mishandled. Not sure if Kefieber still had that ball that was grounded through the infield softly in the previous at bat. Oh, one pitch to Fitch at second. He'll flip in. It can't be handled by the shortstop. I believe that's Cam Coleman at shortstop. He's looking for the easy pitch from Fitch there and a chance to turn two. But now it'll be a man on first and a man on second and only one out for Kefieber. And I do believe we are going to see a change here. I think Michael Hibbs talking to his third base coach down there. Yeah, this is going to be Michael Hibbs, the senior, pinch hitting for Jacob Huddleston. Hibbs, 333 on the year and a 565 on base percentage. He's got five hits and 15 at-bats, three of those extra base hits. So Michael Hibbs, definitely a threat at the plate here with two on. Kefebvre's pitch just low there. Kefebvre kicks. Big swing from Hibbs. Kefebvre in the dirt. Two-one count. One out, two on. Big stick at the plate. Kefebvre will step off. Good move from the junior there to get your bearings. Big spot here for Kefebvre. Looks the runner. Comes to the plate and low again. That'll bring the count to 3-1. Michael Hibbs is in business here. Pitch is called a strike late. Just caught the corner there. Hibbs didn't like it, but that'll bring us full. Kefebvre looks in, sets, comes to the plate, and got him! Hibbs doesn't like it, but Kefebvre sets down his fifth of the day, and Kefebvre has gotten strikeouts at really key moments in this game so far. Strikeouts to end each of the first three innings in a big K there. First pitch is in the dirt. Kefebvre's not done yet, though. Thomas to Hatt. Grounded out in his first appearance. But he's got a 2-0 count to work with here. Two on. Wolves trying to extend their lead. Kefebvre checks the runner, comes to the plate. Big swing. Two-one count to Thomas to Hatt. To Hatt looks at a strike, and now it's an even count. 2-2, two outs. Can Kefebvre work out of this jam? Kefebvre's 2-2 pitch. Grounded down the first baseline. It's going to roll foul. To Hatt staying alive. Lebanon Warriors, as a team, 8.5 ERA and a 2.5 whip. Have had traffic on the base paths, but not too terribly damaging for them so far. We're in the top of the fourth. Kefebvre looks in to Thomas to Hatt. 2-2 pitch. Driven into right field. Ball is high. The right Lebanon Warrior right fielder calls off the infielder. And can't grant Kefebvre works out of the jam. It's 2-0 West Clermont over Lebanon on ICRC-TV.
911, where is your emergency?
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. It made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Look at the Lebanon Warriors dugout. Pleased to have you with us on ICRC-TV. Those Lebanon Warriors trying to claw back against the West Clermont Wolves. Both pitchers doing a solid job. You just saw Grant Kefebver, the junior, work out of a jam, and Caden Yearwood, junior for the Wolves, also staying out there. His first pitch just called a ball there to Peyton Livingston. Livingston, a beauty of a sack bunt in his first appearance. And this time he cracks one into left field. Nice little rope from Peyton Livingston. And the sophomore's on for the first time today. Nice little swing you see on your replay. Driving the hands inside, getting that ball out into shallow left. So the Warriors need some runs here. Bottom of the fourth. And the pitcher at the plate now. See if he can't help himself out. And Grant Kefebver cranked one, but foul. Disrupting the work of those that might relieve him. There is action down there in the Lebanon Warriors bullpen where Kefebver fouled that one off. Yearwood glances over his shoulder. Runner goes. There's going to be no throw. Wolves catcher thought about it, held on to it. Livingston in scoring position now, though. Yearwood 0-2. Pitch. There's a little curve, and it's through over the hill and all the way through the infield. They're going to hold the runner at third. Center fielder was coming up to fire that one in. Probably a good decision to hold the runner at third with no outs. So Grant Kefebver drives one off the pitcher's mound over second base, and Kefebver's put his team in a great position to get some of his runs back. No outs and runners on the corners for Jack Schreck, who's just been dynamite for the Warriors. So a single and a stolen base from Peyton Livingston. And then the starting pitcher, Grant Kefebver, helping himself out.
Let's go, Jack.
Getting on base there. moving Peyton Livingston to third. And our umpire is going to go out and break up the meeting on the hill. Yearwood, a 1.35 whip on the year, 1.05 ERA, but definitely in trouble here with men on the corners and no outs. Tried the little double move, step to third, back to first. Jack Schreck at the dish, though. Schreck is 481 on the year. That is the third best batting average in the Eastern Cincinnati Conference. And a reminder, if you didn't hear, this ECC Athlete of the Week transferred to Lebanon. Catcher one went down the first game. Catcher two went down the second game. And Jack Schreck, with no varsity experiences, stepped up to fill that starting catcher role for the Warriors and is hitting 571, 563 since he took that starting catcher role. He's already saved some runs today, gunning down two runners on the base paths from behind the dish for the Warriors. Now he's got a 2-0 count, men on the corners, and no outs. Yearwood looks, sets. Yearwood's 2-0 pitch, high. Three-oh for Schreck now. And he gets the 4-pitch walk, so Schreck, good eyes, and the catcher's on base right after his pitcher gets on with the signal, and I do believe that is going to be it for Caden Yearwood. That is indeed it for Caden Yearwood. So we will give our new pitcher time to warm up. Stick around. Lebanon Warriors have the bases loaded, no outs.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. Made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Pitching change for the West Clermont Wolves. Caleb Ruberg in for relief of Caden Yearwood. Caleb Ruberg just 1 2/3 on the season. The junior comes in quite the messy spot for the Wolves as Yearwood loaded the bases. The Warriors have Peyton Livingston at third base, who got on with a single, stole, and then advanced on a Grant Kefieber single. Then Kefieber walked to second base after the walk of Jack Schreck. So the Warriors have a chance to dig into this 2-0 deficit. Here in the bottom of the fourth. Ducks on a log, no outs. Ball outside. It's Ryan Land at the plate. The senior popped out in his first appearance today. 292 batting average on the year. Land looks and watches one in the dirt. Get a look at Ruberg on the bump for West Clermont there. Ruberg looks in, kicks, steals in, cracked down the third baseline, foul. Keeps us even 2-2. Another little mound visit here. Gavin Speranza, first baseman, walking over, checking on his pitcher. Grounded to the third baseman. He steps on third, goes to first, and a nice double play by the Wolves. Third baseman Michael Hibbs, who just entered the game last inning, but gets the third base grounder, steps on the bag, goes to first, but Lebanon Warriors do get a run. It's now 2-1 and a runner on second. First pitch to Minnick is outside and back to the fencing. So the runner will advance. Minnick 0 for 1 today. Inside. So Schreck got down to third on the wild pitch. Wolves catcher asks for a new ball, keeping that ball dry as still is damp here in Lebanon. I believe that's Dave Irvick behind the dish for the Wolves. Three-oh count, Ruberg. Kicks, deals. And that is going to be a four-pitch walk for Wyatt Minnick. So it's back to runners on the corners for the Wolves. Cam Coleman coming to the plate. Junior popped out in his first appearance. We'll see if he can't tie this game up. This pitch is in the dirt. You can see things definitely. You get a look at the home plate area there. Definitely caking up a little down there. 1-0 pitch from Ruberg. Right down Broadway. Ervik steps out again. See him looking into his dugout there. Wolves management trying to work out of this without giving up that lead. Uberg's pitch high. Coleman, a 316 hitter, four RBIs on the year. He'll receive the 2-1 pitch and ground it foul down the third baseline. Brings us even to 2-2. Ruberg looks in over at the runner. Will come to the plate. Runner goes from first. Swing strike, but collected by Ervik and throws down to first. And Ruberg gets out of the inning. We'll be back in a moment. Lebanon crawl back with one. It's now 2-1. You're watching ICRC-TV.
If you love them enough to drive an hour to cheer them on as they get beat 11-0 in the rain, then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're correctly buckled in the back seat.
Welcome back to ICRC-TV. We've got lots of baseball this spring, and if you want to help out, there's all the information on your screen for you to get involved, get experience out here broadcasting, and want to give our crew a special shout-out right now for braving the elements as the rain just cranked up a notch here at Lebanon Junior High School. And the Warriors want to keep this thing moving as they brought back a run there in the fourth inning. 2-1 the score now. West Clermont Wolves still lead. Our director, Will Matthews, and our wonderful ICRC-TV crew bringing you all the coverage in the elements. I'm Josh Semstrott. Glad to be along for the ride with you. Eastern Cincinnati Conference Baseball. Both these teams trying to jump into that middle tier of teams in the Eastern Cincinnati Conference. Warriors 3-6 overall, 1-5 in the ECC. Lebanon Warriors. And for the West Clermont Wolves, they are 2-5 overall, 1-4 in the conference, and first pitch is fouled off there by Nate Willison, comes into the game for the Wolves. Willison getting some of his first looks of the year as the pitch from Kefieber sails high. One the count. Fieber comes inside again. Big swing from Willison there. No contact though, and it's 2-2. Kefieber kicks, deals, and gets him swinging. Kefieber sits down another. That's his sixth K of the evening. Just trails off at the end there, and a nice little snag by Jack Schreck to hang on to that. Back to the top with Austin Randolph. Randolph will watch a strike go by. Fieber 1-1. Bunt laid down by Randolph. Handled by the third baseman. Throw over. And a nice play there by the Lebanon Warriors third baseman, Peyton Livingston. Connor Caston be up the plate for the Warriors. Reached on a fielder's choice and an error. He awaits his pitch from Kafieber. It's low and outside. I think Kafieber's starting to have trouble handling the ball. Him and catcher Schreck looking for a dry baseball. Kafieber. This one runs inside. Time of pitch in the dirt. Three-o pitch. This time it'll catch the strike zone. Fieber will walk Caston. Caston's almost hit for the anti-cycle now. It's not on a fielder's choice, an error, and then a base on balls. I'm not sure what the fourth getting hit by a pitch, I guess, would be the round out for that anti-cycle. Stoltz at the plate now for the Wolves. He'll watch one go by and been a great outing so far for Kafieber, but here in the top of the fifth, starting to show a little bit of control issues and it's going to warrant a mound visit. And you can see out there everyone picking at the cleats, trying to get the mud off. The mound isn't looking too terribly bad from my vantage point in the press box here behind home plate. Home plate definitely getting muddy and cakey. Here we go. Fieber comes back with a strike down the pipe, though, after the mound visit. Got a man on, but two outs. Runner goes, throw down from Schreck. Got him! Jack Schreck. Unbelievable from behind the dish. Throws out his third of the day. Stick around.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. It made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
There you see a shot of the home plate area as the rain continues to fall here in Lebanon, Ohio. And just up the street, Miami Valley Gaming, it can get pretty muddy up there when the horses are going on that track in the winter here in Cincinnati. And dirt looking similar to Miami Valley Gaming here at Lebanon Junior High School. And just across the way there, we can see the Lebanon Football Stadium, new turf, part of the Lebanon Legacy Project Phase 1. Miami Valley Gaming kicking in there, helping fund some of those projects. No levy, no taxes for the folks of Lebanon, just donor funding. Some good agreements there by the folks, city leaders in Lebanon. Getting some of that gaming money back into the schools, upgrading some of the athletic facilities, some beautification to Lebanon High School. Some big news at Lebanon High School today as we get underway here in the bottom of the fifth. And that's Caleb Ruberg out there on the bump for Wes Clermont. Came in relief in the middle of the last inning for Caden Yearwood. He's going to stay out there to work hopefully a full inning for the Wolves here. He'll go to work on Hayden Massenheimer. Flied out in his first appearance. Two-oh count flies over the head of Massenheimer. Yeah, big news today at Lebanon High School. Tying into some big news with the Kentucky Wildcats. And no, not that job. John Calipari, longtime coach at Kentucky men's basketball, leaving the program this week. As Massenheimer takes a strike, 3-1 count. For Kentucky women's basketball, some new coaching hires as well that are already in progress. And Lebanon Warriors standout Lindsay Hicks, a 2000 graduate, became the new associate head coach for Kentucky women's basketball today. Huge standout basketball player here in Lebanon. Lindsay Hicks is part of the 2000 class, and her number 45 hangs in the halls, a retired number here at Lebanon. So congratulations to Lindsay Hicks, class of 2000. Hayden Massenheimer works a leadoff walk for the Warriors. Going to have a mound visit here for the Wolves again. So yeah, Hicks, new associate head coach for Kentucky women's basketball. We'll see if anyone from the area takes the big old job after Calipari left. But definitely a cool piece of the story tying back to Lebanon, as you see on your replay there. Definitely getting wet out there. Ball's getting slicker. And I do believe we've reached that official game. If it were to continue raining here, I believe the Warriors get to bat now. But they are at that point where they could call this and make it an official game. As the Wolves make a pitching change, we're going to go to break. We'll be back with the new pitcher on the other side.
If you love them enough to drive an hour to cheer them on as they get beat 11-0 in the rain, then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're correctly buckled in the back seat.
Back at Lebanon Junior High School, where the West Clermont Wolves lead the Lebanon Warriors 2-1. But we're going to see our second pitching change of the evening for West Clermont. Matthew Stathos, the junior, will come in to relieve Caleb Ruberg. Stathos only has about an inning of a third under him and has only struck out one in that small inning and a third. So you see a good shot of the mud caking up around the home plate area there. Looking at my weather radar, we might get a little break in the rain here and be able to play our last few innings. But it is looking mighty close as there is a massive green wall of rain behind it. So Lebanon Warriors, West Clermont Wolves trying to get this game in. 2-1 in the bottom of the fifth. Runner on first for the Warriors. And Matthew Stathos, new pitcher, will go to work. And Warriors trying to do the run and gun there. Bryce Bowman struck out in his first appearance. Look back to his third base coach for instructions there. 0-1 count. Tries to lay down the bunt again. This time pops it back to the fence. Bryce Bowman out of bunting options now as the count is 0-2. No outs. Warriors have had chances. Been able to convert on that once to get the one run back. Still trail by one. They're 326 as a team. That's the second best team batting average in the Eastern Cincinnati Conference. We'll try to lay down the bunt again, and I believe that was, yeah, that was tipped, and that'll be a foul tip on the bunt for the third strike. So Bryce Bowman goes down on strikes again. And Matthew Stathos gets his second strikeout of his young 2024 campaign. Back to the top of the lineup, though, for the Warriors. Ben Fitch will face off against the Southpaw. Kicks and deals. Nice strike from Stathos there. Stathos might be settling into a little groove after the momentum gained from that strikeout. Stathos looking at that runner, comes to the plate, roped into left field. That one's going to get down. Quickly received and thrown in by the Wolves left fielder, but that is a nice little rope into left for Ben Fitch, his second hit of the day. You see on your replay there, great stance from Ben Fitch. Tried to call for time there, I think. You saw on your replay there, definitely seemed like he wanted to step out, but instead steps in and pumps one to left. So it's two on now, first and second for the Warriors. Peyton Livingston at the plate now for the Warriors as we are going to see another mound visit from West Clermont. And I think we are going to see, yes, we're going to see another pitching change. We'll be back with the new Wolf on the mound after the break.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. Made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
I'm Smokey Bear, and I made an assistant to help you prevent wildfires.
Dude, I've got this. I've been camping since I was 5 years old.
But I am a camping influencer.
You know what? I'll bet you $5.
Okay.
Assistant Smokey, what is the best way to put out a campfire?
Mm-hmm.
To put out a campfire, drown with water, stir, drown again, then make sure the fire is out cold by feeling with the back of your hand.
Wait, really?
I'll take the $5.
Back to Lebanon Junior High School. Lebanon Warriors trying to cut into the 2-1 deficit. They've got runners on. Matthew Stathos just left the game, and in to relieve him, Chris Stathos. So the left-handed Stathos out, the right-handed Stathos in. Not sure if they're cousins or twins, both listed as juniors. So we'll see if the Stathos duo can't work out of this jam for Wes Clermont. As the Warriors are up and making noise in their dugout, trying to energize this team and get a run in to tie this game up. There's one out, a man on first and second. Chris Stathos, ball out in front of him. Irvick gets out to retrieve that, keeps the runners where they are. Peyton Livingston's had a good day at the dish. The sophomore had a great sack bunt in his first appearance, a single in his second appearance. He's a .286 hitter on the year, .412 on base percentage. 5 RBI on the year. Livingston watched a nice little floater come in. 1-2. Stathos looks in for a while. He's set. Kicks and deals. Another in the dirt. Runners thought about it. Hold up. Chris Stathos also just about an inning pitched on the year. He's got a 2-2 count. Kicks in and twists around. Nice little move. And Stathos really thought that he had the runner at second. A great little look at second. Wes Clermont wanted another look at that if we had such a thing as a review here. It was a great move from Chris Stathos. Bit of a safer lead now. 2-2 pitch. Shot down the first baseline. Right fielder charging in. And he'll make the catch. Runner's tag. Hold up. So Livingston is sent back to the dugout.
Come on, coach!
And now it'll be Grant Kefieber at the plate, and we're going to see another mound visit from Wes Clermont. So Chris Stathos comes in to face a batter, and he'll leave the game. So we'll be back after this.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. Made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
back here in Lebanon, Ohio, a new pitcher on the mound for West Clermont. Will be their fifth pitcher of the day, sophomore Cam Anderson. Anderson, five innings pitched on the year, six strikeouts in those five innings. But not always making it easy, a 2.4 whip. And the sophomore in a big spot. Warriors still trying to find that tying run. So Grant Kefieber, the junior at the plate for the Lebanon Warriors. He has six strikeouts on the bump today, pitching for the Warriors, and he's helped out at the plate as well. One for two. First pitch is in the dirt. Back to the fence hard. Runners will advance. So Will Ault down at third base now. Two in scoring position, but two outs. Anderson in is a big spot as the home crowd can feel this big opportunity for the Warriors. Anderson's 1-0, again low and away. Kefieber's 345 hitter on the year, 424 on base percentage. And in terms of RBIs, the kid leads the conference, Grant Kefieber, 13 RBIs coming into the day. That is number one in RBI for the Eastern Cincinnati Conference. We'll see if he's greenlit on the 3-0 two-out pitch from Anderson. No. And he is pumped up, drawing the four-pitch walk. Kefieber down to first base on the walk. Bases are loaded for the Warriors. And as for the Warriors, I'm not sure you want anyone else up at the plate right now. The catcher, Jack Schreck, standout transfer to Lebanon. Schreck is hitting 481 on the season, third best in the Eastern Cincinnati Conference. First pitch, strike. Cam Anderson comes right at Jack Schreck. Sophomore versus junior here, this time inside. And Dane Irvick's got to be careful behind the dish here. Makes a good stop there, but West Clermont really doesn't want to have a wild pitch go by. 1-1 from Anderson coming to Schreck. Inside.
All you five, let's go!
Schreck has grounded out and walked today. Schreck calls for time. So you see that rain has paused. 2-1 pitch from Anderson. Cranked up the middle. Will it get through? No, the shortstop is there. Grabs it, steps on second, and Wes Clermont gets out of the bases loaded jam. 2-1 is our score still. We head to the top of the sixth.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. Made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
Yeah.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Welcome back. You're on ICRC-TV. Pleasure to have you with us here at Lebanon Junior High School. I'm Josh Semstrott, bringing you the sights and sounds. Will Matthews, our director, and our wonderful ICRC-TV crew out here braving the elements. West Clermont holding momentum. And for their coach, Dave Collins, one thing he told Cincy Preps in their season preview, quote, "Our pitching staff and defense will anchor our team." So definitely some great pitching, a lot of pitchers used there in the fourth and fifth inning, but nevertheless, the West Clermont Wolves work out of it despite all the traffic on the base paths, and the Wolves keep momentum. Speaking of momentum for the Wolves, West Clermont School District received the Momentum Award from the state for their efforts last year. Progress on their school district report card measures a lot of key performances and metrics across the school district, and so much progress and efforts were made last year that the state recognized West Clermont District with the Momentum Award this past March. So a lot of good news for both of these school districts. A lot of improvements both in and out of the classroom, on and off the field for both these districts. And we're underway in the sixth inning. I want to tell you about the new pitcher for the Lebanon Warriors. After Grant Faber's day is done, he ended the day with six strikeouts. This one's cracked down the third base line. Nice backhanded glove and throw over. A nice play by Peyton Livingston. So one down here in the sixth. Austin Milligan, the new pitcher for Lebanon. The junior has six innings under his belt this season. Three Ks on the season as well. Oh, wow, late appeal. We'll get the strike called. Milliken kind of glanced over at the umpire who is standing down there on the first base line. Milliken from the windup. Just low. A lot of guys today been working out of the stretch regardless of the situation. Full windup here for Austin Milliken, a good one. But he's down in a 3-1 count. Kyle Gillespie at the plate for West Clermont. He awaits the pitch. Blasts one in between third base and shortstop. And Gillespie's on with a leadoff single. See on your replay here, just patient. And a chop swing. Trickle one through the infield and get the leadoff runner aboard for West Clermont. Riley Wooldridge, the senior, is in for Caleb Dorisette. Wooldridge, Wooldridge, excuse me, senior is batting 158 this season. Throw over to first, keeping that runner honest. Mulliken, low and away. Mulliken much faster to the plate out of the stretch. Pitch again is outside. Mulliken looks the runner back, comes to the plate, swinging strike. And Shrek thought about throwing down to first. Two pitch, Mulliken outside again. Three-two pitch for Wooldridge. He awaits the pitch from Mulliken. Popped up. Shallow right field. Right fielder just calls off the second baseman at the last second. But the play is made. So two outs now for Lebanon. Gavin Speranza at the plate for West Clermont now. He'll go down 0-1. Speranza, one of the standouts on this West Clermont team. All ECC first team last year. The Wolves still have another year with him next year. He hits a hard grounder to the third baseman who goes to second, and it rolls by the second baseman into right field. Right fielder can't handle it. And finally going to be thrown into second there. And Warriors probably thankful that grass is a little wet and that ball didn't roll further, allow a run. It was a hard shot to third base by Speranza there. And Fitch just couldn't handle the throw from Livingston. It'll be runners on the corners now for Michael Hibbs. Hibbs struck out earlier, but is a 333 hitter coming into today. Watches the floater just high there. Mulliken just outside. Mulliken in a tricky situation here. 2-0, two outs, runners on the corners, and we are in the top of the sixth of seven innings played here at the high school varsity level, so don't want to be conceding another run after keeping the game close for, well, most of the evening. Early trouble in the first inning for the Lebanon Warriors, but have really kept the game close and had quite a few chances to tie this game up. But the pitching and defense from West Clermont, and now Shrek. Shrek running the second baseman down and is just going to let him go to second. Good hold there from Mulliken. Almost had the runner in the pickle, but Warriors just need one more strike, just need one more out. Junior back from the windup now and gets the outside call. Huge pitch from the junior Austin Mulliken to set the Wolves down. And now the bats need to come out for the Lebanon Warriors as we head to the bottom of the sixth inning. 2-1 is your score. West Clermont still leads.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. It made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Welcome back to Lebanon, Ohio. Lebanon Warriors taking on the West Clermont Wolves, and they trail 2-1. It's the bottom of the sixth here, so only two more chances for the Warriors. Cam Anderson came in the last inning for the Wolves. He's their fifth pitcher of the day, so they're gonna let him go again here in his first pitch, low and away to Ryan Land. Ryan Land popped out and then RBI off the fielder's choice in his last at-bat. Pops one foul and is going to go out of play. Ryan Land, 292 average. On the year, 5 RBI. He's got 2 stolen bases if he could get on. High pop up there. Just beyond second base. And the Wolves' second baseman is there for the putout. Wyatt Minnick. 0-for-1 today, walked in his last at-bat, takes a first pitch strike from Anderson. One. Anderson to the plate. Yes. Blasted into center field. Line drive. And it's gotten by the center fielder on the diving attempt. Minnick going to stay at first. And a nice shot into the grasses of center field for Minnick. And we are going to have a pinch hitter here, Keith Schilt. In his first season here at Lebanon, making the change. Looks like he's going to go with Ben Williams.
Now batting for the Warriors, number 4, Ben Williams.
In for Cam Coleman. Ben Williams is a junior, hitting 250 on the season. 429 on base percentage, though. He's got 5 RBIs, 3 stolen bases. See what he can do here. Takes a pitch upstairs. 1-1. Hard foul ball out of play. 1-2. Minnick on first base, just one stolen bag this year. Decent lead over there, though. 1-2 pitch, got him looking. And Ben Williams, a pitch hitter, is sent back. Cam Anderson with his first strikeout of the year, of the game, his seventh of the year. So Hayden Massenheimer to the plate now. 0 for 1 today. Walked in his last appearance. Pitch way upstairs from Anderson. Big cut. The junior awaits the 1-1. Upstairs again.
Go, Hayden.
Two hits in 9 at-bats. For Hayden Massenheimer. Watches another ball go by. 3-1. Lebanon has a runner at first. They need a run here in the bottom of the sixth. And Hayden Massenheimer watches the fourth ball go by low, and now it's two base runners for the Warriors. Keith Schilt going to make another substitution here. So Ben Fitch was due up and it's 2 for 3 on the day, but Coach Schilt want to make a change and go with Nolan Cummings. The junior, 267 on the year, 353 on base percentage, 2 RBI, and 2 extra base hits. But before Cummings gets his chance, drive in a run here. Let's see another mound visit for West Clermont. Do believe this one is just going to be a visit, though. And I think Lebanon head coach Keith Schilt is asking our home plate umpire, how many visits does a team get in a game? As the Warriors have had quite a few meetings on the hill today. And now we are going to see a meeting between umpires after the discussion with Lebanon head coach Keith Schilt. Our umpires beyond the pitcher's mound. Again, it's 2 outs, 2 men on for Lebanon. We are in the bottom of the sixth, score 2-1. Warriors really trying to get a run here. So Keith Schilt, I believe, was asking for clarification on a count or substitution there. Sounds like he didn't get away, but we're back to action here. And again, we do have a pinch hitter here for Lebanon Warriors, Nolan Cummings. Takes a first pitch ball. 1-0 from Anderson. That one's down the pipe. Evens things up. Pitch from Anderson outside. Two-one pitch from Anderson in the dirt, and a nice job by Ervik to stop that one. Ervik's done a nice job for the most part today getting on top of these wild pitches. Quite a lot of room behind the dish here at Lebanon. 3-1 count. And another strike looking there. So Cummings has watched two strikes go by. He's also watched three balls. It is a full count, two outs. Cummings steps out. Good pause there for a breath in this big moment. Full count from Anderson. Cummings, a dribbler, second baseman handles, throw to first. And once again, Wes Clermont gets out of the inning without allowing a run, and they maintain their short little lead as we head to the final inning. We'll be back with the seventh on ICRC-TV in a moment.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. Made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Top of the seventh, it's our final inning here in Lebanon, Ohio. The West Clermont Wolves lead the Lebanon Warriors 2-1, and I do want to commend both the coaching staffs, everyone that worked on the field today, all of our student athletes that worked on the field, were on tarp duty, our umpires for getting here early. It's a loaded schedule in April, and a lot of these kids, especially if they're seniors, you just want to play as much as you can. This is my first time back at this field since some of my last games, my senior year. And some good memories they were going out on a high note on this field many years ago. But you always think of the old line in Moneyball, we're all told, some of us at different ages, but we're all told you never know when your last games are going to be. And on a day like this, it can be hard to get those games in. It can be hard to play every day when you're a student athlete in April. But these coaches, administrators, umpires, and student athletes have worked hard to get this game in today, get our facilities ready, and we've made it to the last inning and still have a little bit of a break in the weather. Warriors finishing up a decent homestand here. They got a great matchup with LaSalle tomorrow. First pitch from Mulliken's fouled back. It's Thomas DeHatt at the plate for the Wolves. And Tahat's down early, 0-2. And then, yeah, for the West Clermont Wolves, they finally get to go home and enjoy a little bit of a homestand straddling this weekend and a couple days off as well. After this three-game homestand for West Clermont, they have 8 of their next 10 games on the road. Mulliken just misses on the upstairs corner. One-two pitch from Mulliken. Little dribbler handled by Livingston. Going to spin. Got him. Nice play by Livingston. Made it look easy. The third baseman's had a couple good plays today over there on the hot corner. Not a lot of time afforded to you on a thicker grass, wet grass, a little dribbler like that. And he added the little flair with the spin. Always like to see that from the left side of the infield. We're going to have a pinch hitter now for West Clermont. Maybe. Maybe not. It'll be Tyler Reek. So Reek steps in and big, big cut. Misses and it's 0-1. A 1 from Mulliken's upstairs. Great pitch from Mulliken there. Slowing it up. And it's 1-2. Crack down to the first baseman. I think he's just going to take that himself. Almost thought about it a little too long there, did Ryan Land. Land handles it, though, and there's two outs for the Warriors. Warriors are aching to get back and get the bats going. We are in the top of the seventh. Mulliken from the windup goes behind the batter. Austin Randolph, leadoff hitter for the Wolves. And the leading man in the Eastern Cincinnati Conference, a .500 hitter, .625 on base percentage. He's got 6 steals, one of them today. 2 runs scored. He came across the plate for both of West Clermont's runs, and he sends one into right field opposite way. It's just going to get down inside the foul line. Recovered by and the right fielder, and the throw in had a chance if it was online, but pulls the shortstop off the bag, and a great double there for Austin Randolph. It's his second hit of the game. Fourth extra base hit of the season. Austin Randolph, force to be reckoned with, name atop a lot of the batting statistic categories in ECC. Randolph was ECC second team last year. Randolph, ECC second team last year, but so far in the 2024 campaign, it's definitely making a case for first team honors. So after little meeting on the hill. Austin Milliken will go back to work. Runner on second. Milliken kicks and deals. Just inside. Milliken that time gets the call. Evens us 1-1. Two balls, one strike. Milliken to the plate. This one gets by and isn't going to kick back very nicely for Schreck. That'll allow the runner to advance. Warriors have been in this situation a few times today. Two outs, runners on. Just need to get that last guy. Three balls, one strike. From the windup, Milliken. Cracked right back to him. Can't handle it right at first. Almost slips off the back of the mound and makes the play. Milliken hangs in there. Coming to the plate, handling himself off of the mound and making the play. One last chance for the Warriors when we return. You're watching ICRC-TV.
I felt accomplished after I got my diploma. It made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
If you need to do something to feel okay to drive, you're not okay to drive. Don't drive buzzed.
Welcome back to ICRC-TV. You've been watching Eastern Cincinnati Conference baseball, and you get a look at the Eastern Cincinnati Conference standings. Kings and Milford running at the top there, undefeated in conference play so far. You see West Clermont and Lebanon down at the bottom there. A win today would move one of these teams up into that middle pack there. Want to try and float above 500 through the beginning of April and start putting it together. As we've touched on a little bit, it can just be such a packed schedule for these teams. Lebanon, they're finally going to get a day off this weekend, Saturday and Sunday, but they have basically been chugging through this April schedule so far, just about a game a night and getting the weekends off. About the same for West Clermont. But yeah, for you Lebanon fans, get out there. April 24th, it's a Wednesday game, but such a cool stadium up there, Day Air Park in downtown Dayton, home of the Low A affiliate. So just had a Wolves player slip off the mound, leaving the meeting. But yeah, Kings, one of our first place teams here in the Eastern Cincinnati Conference, and Lebanon, April 24th at Day Air Park. And then another good one, Saturday, May 4th at Wright State University, Lebanon and Chaminade Julien. Leadoff pitch sent into center field, but shallow right field to the second baseman. I thought Ben Fitch really got a lot more of that one. It's still Cam Anderson out on the mound for Wes Clermont trying to close this game out. He just needs two more outs. Peyton Livingston now for Lebanon. As you see on your screen there, the rain starting to fall again. Good. 1-0 pitch is in the dirt again. Warriors dugout trying to keep the energy up and stay in this ball game. Two-o pitch. Livingston will watch that one go by for a strike. Time Livingston fouls it off, and we're even at two balls, two strikes. Sack bunt, single, fly out for Livingston today. So you get a look at Anderson trying to keep that baseball dry. His 2-2 pitch. Upstairs, and we're full. Warriors need a base runner. Anderson hits the bag and toes the rubber. Full count pitch. And grounder to the second baseman takes a little bit of a weird hop off the grass, but handled in a routine play, and Lebanon is down to their final out. So the man that started our game, Grant Kiefaber, six strikeouts when he was pitching earlier today, was the Lebanon starting pitcher and has done well at the plate as well. A single and a walk. Kiefaber looks in. Ball is way behind him. See Anderson really hitting that rosin bag out there, kind of more than you've seen a lot of these other pitchers doing today, but the rain is starting to pour steadily now. And it's a 3-0 count for Grant Kiefaber. Jack Schreck, one of the conference's best hitters, has been quiet today. He's on deck. Anderson's 3-0 pitch is inside, and Kiefaber walks for his second consecutive appearance at the plate. As the rain really starts to come down now as we're in the closing stages of this game.
Now batting for the Warriors, number five,
Jack Schreck. Flied out, walked, grounded out. But Schreck, the junior newcomer here to Lebanon, 41 hitter, 500 on base percentage. We'll see what he can do here. And we'll see how long he has, as we are in full rain showers mode now. 1-1 is the count. Nice frame job there from Dane Ervik. Pulled the pitch back and gets the strike call. This one's fouled off. We'll stay at 1-2. This is where you find out what your guys are made of. Can you handle the elements? Can you handle the big spot? 1-2 pitch, called strike, and that's the game. Cam Anderson shuts the door.
Come on, Blue.
And that is the ball game. So 2-1, it was an early start for the game and an early start for West Clermont as they took the first inning lead and never really looked back. Two runs off five hits. Lebanon Warriors also five hits but can only get the one run across. The Wolves end with four strikeouts on the day, and Cam Anderson with two huge strikeouts at the end of the game. Caden Yearwood will get the win. Grant Kefaber, although a great performance today from him, six strikeouts, he will take the loss. But the West Clermont Wolves victorious today on a soggy evening. I want to thank you for joining us on ICRC-TV. For my director and crew, Will Matthews, and the great ICRC-TV production staff, it's 2-1 West Clermont over the Lebanon Warriors. Josh Semstrat signing off. We'll see you next time.